fiercest man in this ancient sport of bodybuilding, and today the world's top amateurs have assembled to stake claim to the title Mr. Universe. Welcome to the Wild Wild West in Tucson, Arizona. We're at the Tucson Community Center Music Hall. I'm Tim Brando, along with Chris Dickerson, who has won just about every title you can win in the sport of bodybuilding. And it's the Mr. Universe competition we have today. And we should mention at the very top that we have the best the world has to offer at the amateur level, Chris.
That's for sure, Tim. We're seeing the best of the best of these men today. They come from all over the world, we're proud to say. There's one man in particular who's very outstanding, the biggest man in the competition. Of course, I don't know if he'll win, and his name is Marlon Darton, and he's just fantastic. The other men, of course, will be vying for the title as well. Biggest is not always best, of course.
Let's talk a little bit about the format structure for judging. There are four weight categories, four weight classifications, and there is a champion in each of those classifications.
That's correct, and these are divided by weight divisions to make it a fair competition. And of course, from these four, we pick the overall. Now, the judges look for symmetry, proportion, and muscularity. These are the three prerequisites to a great physique today. The posing is very important too. And you cannot deny that a person who displays his body the best to the music he selected, choreographed specifically for him, that weighs into the final outcome of the competition.
It is a competition, but it is also a performance. There are some looming thespians out here. It does have a bearing on the outcome of a championship, doesn't it?
Oh, yes. You've got to be an entertainer today. You just can't be a bodybuilder who flexes his muscles. It's all changed now. And that's why some of the bodybuilders, you know, they get Broadway choreographers. I've seen it done. And, you know, you have to put a lot of pizzazz in the routines today. It's not like the old school at all.
All right, we'll have the pizzazz, the razzmatazz, and a lot of bodybuilding underway here at the Mr. Universe pageant in Tucson. Stay right where you are.
In Tucson, Tim Brando and Chris Dickerson, we're ready now for the lightweights. John Kennedy will get it started out of Brooklyn, New York. And as John comes out, Chris, what are the judges looking for early during these routines?
Basically, Tim, this is the performance round. And the judges want to see how prepared the poser is, that he's worked the music or his movements to the music on the beat. And this has to do with dynamics, changing of dynamics, showing the physique all the while, to sort of suiting the action to the music here.
John is a diamond setter in Brooklyn.
He shows his back. You've got to show all the different angles of the physique, front, back, side. They like to see kneeling poses, poses from the floor also.
And a nice round of applause for Kennedy as Sean Swilling begins to make his way out from South Africa. One of many from that country that have performed well in the sport of bodybuilding.
This is the hard part. You wait for your music to start. I've been in this position myself, and you just die up there. It seems like forever. It does happen no matter how prepared you are, so he's just waiting it out.
He is bench pressed a lot, and he's also had a 375-pound squat in his back.
Very different from the last man. More dramatic, as you can see. See how the movements suit the music? Right on the beat.
Those are very definite beats as well, aren't they? That's an easy piece of music to work with.
It is a good selection. Very dramatic, definite. The judges like to see this sort of action. Hard poses, flexing the muscle part. Good routine, I'd say.
Sean Swilling from South Africa. Let's go to Chris Liddy now.
How did you first get into this sport of bodybuilding?
3 years ago, I was diagnosed as a diabetic, and I was told to exercise. And I tried a bit of running, and I landed up in the gym.
That's quite a story.
Yeah, I find it's made an incredible difference. I managed to control myself really well with my insulin and my training. I've cut down my insulin by a good 60%.
Sean may be taking insulin, giving the fans here a great deal of adrenaline with that performance, and we'll be right back. Stay with us. here at the Mr. Universe Bodybuilding Championships in Tucson, Tom Ruffino from Phoenix, Arizona, representing the United States, is ready to get underway. 32 years of age.
Starting with the back shot, a kneeling position, a bit of a mystery added to that. Very dramatic opening.
He makes the most of his 173 pounds, doesn't he?
Yeah, and he's also having fun. When he's having fun enjoying himself, the audience relaxes and enjoys his performance. Another back shot. That could be critical. He could have mixed the poses a little bit differently. He's repeating some of them.
Asked why he got into bodybuilding, he said it was because he wanted the therapy. And many of them will tell you that.
Has very good command of the stage. Moves very well, very easily from one pose to the next.
Tom Ruffino from Phoenix, Arizona, nearby Tucson, getting a nice round of applause. And here comes Quincy Roberts. Now, he is big and he is thick. And he's from Greensboro, North Carolina, 30 years of age. I know you like his physique.
Very good. They're hard. Traditional double arm pose there, twisting back shot. This man is definitely in top condition. Another twisting back shot.
He's only been building his body for 8 years. Looks like 20 years worth of accomplishment there.
I would say so. Back lat spread. Got an incredible back. He's showing it off. Every pose should show off what they have to advantage. Here's extending the leg, now kneeling. The crab shot, the classic crab shot, as we call it.
And an outstanding performance for Ruffino, and let's go to him now with Chris.
Robert!
How did you put your routine together, your posing routine?
Well, I just start out seeing what poses look the best, then I try to choreograph them together, and then I put my music together with that, you know, just kind of slow music, so that, you know, I can hold the poses and then hit a few fast shots.
Glenn Marshman now from Lafayette, Colorado, ready to perform, 30 years of age, he weighs 175 pounds. Sort of a macho piece of music.
Yeah, it is that. He's doing standard poses. I like a little more flair in this routine. See what he does here. Back most muscular pose. Last spread again.
He's won virtually every title in Colorado, from the Rocky Mountains to Mr. Colorado.
Nice move.
There's not much doubt that the muscularity and definition are there, if not imagination, in that performance by Glenn Marshman of Colorado. He is with Chris Dickerson. Let's go over to them now.
Glenn, I'm really struck by your symmetry and your proportion and how evenly you developed your physique. Is there a secret to that? Can you give the listeners some hint as to just how you do this? It's not easy to do that. A lot of bodybuilders are disproportionate, either too much upper, too much lower. You've done a very even job of that. How do you do it?
Well, for one, I think I'm pretty lucky to have the symmetry like that. I try and train all my body parts equally so that nothing lags behind. If there's something that's a little bit weak, I try and stay a little bit more on that weaker body part.
Kevin Kelson, one of the many native sons from here in Tucson now, 30 years of age at 171 pounds, ready to perform for the home folks. They like him too, don't they?
Yep. Hometown favorite.
Mr. Greater Tucson in 83 and 84, Mr. Arizona overall that same year.
Very nice pose here for Kelson. Very good shape, displaying it pretty well.
We already mentioned Quincy Roberts' fine upper body. Now, how does his lower body, Kelson, compare with Roberts?
Very good. Very good calf development. He's not big, particularly big anywhere, which is good. Pretty even. Legs lag a little behind, but that's typical.
Kelson began in bodybuilding just 4 years ago, so Roberts has double the advantage on him in time in this sport.
Good flexes right on the beat, very deliberate. Flexing hard. Showing off the legs, he's got them.
Kevin Kelson from Tucson, Arizona wraps up the middleweight classification and will continue from Tucson, the site of this year's Mr. Universe Bodybuilding Championship. Dickerson, our analyst for the Mr. Universe Bodybuilding Championships, and now Lloyd Clark out of Asheboro, North Carolina, will get the light heavyweights underway here.
Now the music is going and he's not yet posing. Now this looks indecisive on the part of the competitor, and the judges really don't like this. Necessarily a young man's sport, and that's the beauty of bodybuilding. It's you and the weights, and it's your progress.
Lloyd is a diesel mechanic, owns his own fitness center in Asheboro.
Well, I'd say his physique is ahead of his performance based on what I've seen. Not quite into it.
Didn't appear as comfortable, perhaps, as he would have liked for the crowd here in Tucson. And now, Gordon Pasquill from England. Boy, he appears pumped up.
He's ready, fired up.
In more ways than one, he's pumped up. He's only been bodybuilding, Chris, for 3 years. Amazing what he's been able to do in that short period of time.
Got to shake a little bit. Sometimes you can overflex to the point of view of flexing too hard and your muscles shake. Got to be careful with that. Not nervousness.
31 years old, very animated fellow, and an outstanding personality. Become a crowd favorite. He's enjoying it, that's for sure. already Mr. United Kingdom and representing England here in this competition today.
Pretty fancy trunks there. Muscle control, few contractions there. You don't see that very much these days.
Is that considered gimmickry?
A little bit. It's a feat to be able to isolate the muscles that way. It doesn't necessarily please the judges. I'd say his routine here lacks flow and just lacks poise all around. It's not a pleasing routine to watch.
Gordon might disagree with you though, Chris. He seemed pretty pleased.
You've only got a minute or so to prove yourself. Mm-hmm. And you know, you've got to do everything. You've got to try and respond to the audience. And if they're with you, it's great, you know. If I come last, I'm not bothered because I know the audience are with me. And I feel good about it.
You're from England. How is bodybuilding in England as compared to the United States? Is that as well accepted?
Bodybuilding, believe it or not, in our country is the fifth most popular sport in our country. It's very, very well accepted. We consider the Americans obviously the best. But we reckon ourselves we've got a good second. And we try and emulate the Americans. But bodybuilding in Britain, England is big. Yeah, definitely.
And he's getting bigger in this competition. Taking a big look at the body on Gregory Long out of Pennsylvania.
Done a very good job filling it out, I'd say. Long and thick.
Of age, but he's been at it. He's been at bodybuilding since 14.
Gregory Long is a gym owner, and he says it doesn't interfere with his own training with the long hours it demands. Pretty good posing here.
He does 300-pound curls. You can pretty much tell with that pose there.
Very powerful position. These kneeling poses aren't easy for tall men. Practice.
Finished fourth in his weight class in the Mr. World competition. Finished second in the Mr. USA competition, the AAU Mr. USA in 86. He's been around, he's a veteran, and he's showing you with this performance.
Could be a little tighter around the lower back, around the midsection.
He says that when he's away from the gym, he likes to go backpacking. Well, he's got a big enough back to pack.
Good music selection.
Gregory Long from Pennsylvania. Here comes that Pasadena youngster named Doug Brignole, who at 26 is considered a star of the future in the sport of bodybuilding.
Lots of symmetry here. Waiting for his music. Now already he's showing much more poise than most of the other competitors. Displaying his physique fully in control.
At 198 pounds, he does have the symmetry, but he's not as big as some of the others in his weight class. He doesn't seem to be as wide or as thick.
But that's what's not as important as you might think. He's very evenly developed, and physiques like this usually win. We'll see, it should be interesting. Better to be even than not so big or, on the other hand, small in another area.
He's a nutritionist and has really put a lot of value, a lot of stock in that part of his game and making him stronger and better in this competition.
Very deliberate in his poses.
In fact, the reason that he got into bodybuilding was to gain weight. He said he was just too small as the young athletes coming up in grade school, junior high, and high school.
I'm very impressed with his performance, very impressed with his physique.
To this point, it appears he does have the best of both worlds, the upper as well as lower body proportions.
Exactly, Tim.
While he may be concerned about size, he doesn't have to be concerned at all about his performance in this category here today.
What's always frustrated me was that I really wasn't able to get the size that a lot of the other people could. I've beat a lot of bigger guys, so I really can't say that it's hurt me all that much. And the general public probably likes my style of build better because I look more normal in street clothes than the average bodybuilder, and yet I can still hold pretty high titles. So as frustrated as I am by not being able to get in the size, or as much size as I've wanted, I guess it's for the better.
If the shoe fits, wear it. If the shoe fits on the heavies as we continue here in Tucson. See what could be, in fact, the star of this show. Marlon Darton. To start the heavyweight category out of Tucson, Arizona, and everyone's favorite, including yours, Chris.
Well, I shouldn't say that, but he's awfully impressive. He's from Tucson, as you said, and he's got the crowd behind him, and he feels good and looks good.
As you said at the top of the show, he is the biggest. He'll have to prove that he's the best.
Exactly. Is incredible. The upper body, the calves a little bit weak. My only criticism of the physique itself. He's displaying himself very well. Got some flair to it, some dramatics. Look at his back.
He has a 17-month-old daughter going to school to become an actor and be a starring role in a motion picture coming out very soon.
Showing the physique from all sides, making a circle, kneeling here.
I think the acting part is really coming to the forefront here. He seems to be the most comfortable of any that we've seen thus far.
He is comfortable before people, and it's important. He's also prepared. When you're really prepared, you just take the stage. Makes a difference. He feels he belongs up there. Very nice.
Marlon Darton with an outstanding performance.
Marlon, Chris mentioned that at the very top of the show that he thought you would be the favorite for the overall title here, and this performance in front of your home folks has you smiling, I know that.
Oh, man, it's the greatest feeling in the whole world, man, to be at home. And my family gets to finally see me in action, and I'm real proud to be here.
What does it mean to perform here in Tucson before the home folks, as opposed to if you go somewhere else? Or is there a carryover?
Well, it's an honor by the fact that when I was a child growing up into body, you know, wanting to be a bodybuilder, and to be finally able to come into a sport and be considered one of the world's best, and to have it at home is even, it's astronomical. I can't describe and put into words.
The competition, though, is getting bigger and better for Marlon Darton as Keith Whitley, a big youngster out of Irving, Texas, is ready to perform.
Now, let's watch Keith. I'm very impressed with his overall development. He's not as defined as some of the others, though. You're doing on stage, it can be a distraction.
We talked about all of this and what the judges look for, but how much will a body mass take away from music selection, or music selection choreography take away from a body mass?
Well, it's by and large, it's basically a physique competition. You got to keep that in mind. But this is a performance round. So the selection, how you display your physique, if you're in sync with the music, it all plays a part in this round. I'd say his selection of music is very poor here. I think that'll hurt his standing. He's doing one thing, the music is doing another. It's inappropriate.
He's only been in the sport for a short time. You've got to say that he's got a definite future in this weight class, somebody for Darton to be concerned about in the years that
follow. Very much, very much. Wow. Quite a physique.
So that's Keith Whitley out of Irving, Texas. And the competition continues here in Tucson as Glenn Kinnear comes to the forefront. Now, Kinnear, Mr. World this year, overall in the short class, Mr. America short class overall. I guess you'd have to say this is the creme de la creme of opponents for Darton in this weight class. He does have the experience and the physique necessary.
That's for sure. He's having quite a year. Let's see what he does today. Snowballing, I think. Good so far. Like it.
That is from nearby Phoenix, Arizona. One thing I notice about these guys from Arizona is that they have the tan. Now, how much does the color of the skin add in the
Oh, day? Quite a lot, Tim, because the light will take a lot of the glare and take some of the muscularity away from you if you pale. The darker you are on stage, the harder you appear. It's an illusion, but there it is. Good variety of poses here. I like to see him do a kneeling pose or a lunge pose, which he didn't do.
How do you like that, Glenn Kinnear?
You really love to smile. I noticed you were giving the crowd and the judges as much of that as you were flexing those muscles. Is that key for you to let them know and for every competitor, hey, I'm having a good time out here?
Well, I came here to have a good time, and I sure am doing just that. I'm coming off a real good year. I've won the Mr. World in April. I won the Mr. America 2 weeks ago, and I hope I can come out ahead today.
It won't be long now before we know who the champions are in each weight class. Stay with it.
Chris, and
you talked
about Marlon Dalton, and Marlon Dalton was outstanding in his routine.
He's a mean guy. I hate to stand next to him. He's just incredible. Big, he's got the muscularity, he's got the skin tone, all of it. Very evenly developed. He's got competition, though.
When you look at the pose down, though, you're talking about Glenn Kinnear. This is a guy that's won Mr. America. He's won
2 weeks ago only.
And it's obviously an opportunity for him to show a bigger guy what he can do in that pose down. What chance does he have?
Very hot chance, I'd say, because they're very different. Dalton's very tall. The other man's shorter, but in a sense more evenly developed. Not as impressive overall, but the impressiveness sometimes isn't what it takes. It's got to be the whole thing put together. And, of course, that's where my strength would lie, in the whole thing being put together.
I think we found perhaps a star on the horizon in the youngster from Irving, Whitley. He is a big one.
He's a big guy. Keith Whitley is very, he's like your Incredible Hulk.
Mm-hmm.
He's just very impressive. Superhero type. Huge. Very thick.
Now, in the pose down, how long will these guys have to go at it? I mean, doesn't it get a little bit trying from time to time on them?
It does. I guess the adrenaline takes the guys through it. I've been through this, too. The judges are tabulating their scores, so they just want to take one final look to see who really is the best. And sometimes it takes a while, and you have differences of opinion, and sometimes the guys will say, well, let's see them again. And then you'll have round three until the final they decide, phew, we want this man, but it's not easy. It's not easy. It's all, sometimes it's apples and oranges, because one's as good as the other one. They're just different types.
Now in the pose down for the lightweight, Sean Swilling came away with the championship. John Kennedy finished in second, and Henry Anton was third. In the middleweight category, Quincy Roberts took the title with Glenn Marshman finishing second and Kelvin Kelson third. Roberts has that impressive upper body, and he will have a chance for the Mr. Universe overall title. All of that and other pose downs yet to come from here in Tucson. competition, the pose down underway. And Chris, what are they trying to do here?
Well, they're trying to upstage each other. For one thing, they want the judge to look at them, say, hey, look at me, I'm the best man. That's what they're saying, with their physiques. And one gets in front of the other. Now here we have a very impressive back shot from Brignole. I say he's the man to beat here. The others have to catch up to him. He's my favorite so far in this class. Everyone's showing off their stuff, as we say.
That's Patrick Quill, the young man from England.
They're all determined here.
Have a last turn. That's long. And now it's all up to the judges to make their decision on the Mr. Universe Light Heavyweight Champion.
Please welcome our finalists. We could get our fifth place winner to the far side of the platform from England, Gordon Pasquale.
Well, he'll be back. He's maybe a slightly disappointed being fifth, but he's making the top five in this group is quite an accomplishment.
And particularly
our
coming over from
England.
Our
fourth place winner is from South Africa, Kevin McNamara.
McNamara has a wife. It's a female bodybuilder and an outstanding one at that, Kathy.
In third place, from the United States,
now
Craig Long.
He's happy with his third place. Now,
in second place, from the United States, Lloyd Clark, the winner of the Mystery Universe.
Well, everybody better watch out for Brignole.
Doug Brignole.
Doug did his homework. He's well prepared, very evenly developed, and it paid off.
At only 26, he's got quite a future. We're ready now for the heavyweight pose down. And of course, the man that everyone's shooting for is that man, Marlon Darton.
The back pose here, here we go. This is the part that the audience enjoys quite a lot. They cheer their favorite. The judges are making up their minds. One final look.
Whitley is exercising his strongest point to the left of your screen.
I say he's the biggest man on stage, considering his leg development. He could be more defined, harder.
Knerr is obviously a game opponent for Darton. But again, Darton just seems so much more composed, particularly with the rest of them out there with him.
Everything just popped out at you with him. He's just so defined and hard.
And we're ready for the decision now.
In fifth place, from Colorado, Brian McCluskey.
Good place.
In fourth place, representing Texas, Keith Whitley.
Well, Whitley has a ways to go, but he certainly has the foundation.
That he does. I think not being in such great condition hurt him.
In third place, Mr. America, Mr. World, Glenn Kinnear.
Probably a little bit of a surprise to Kinnear to finish third.
He's visibly disappointed, you can see that.
In second place, John L'Heureux.
L'Heureux second, and that means Darton's got it, and look how excited he is. That picture pretty much tells the story. The togetherness in the sport of bodybuilding, and right now, Darton's light is shining brightly over his hometown of Tucson. I see a few tears there.
Very emotional. Great moment.
Marlon Darton has wrapped up the heavyweight. Now he goes for all of it in the Mr. Universe Championship. With the Mr. Universe Bodybuilding Championships here in Tucson, and all four of our category winners have that chance. Sean Swilling, the lightweight category champion, has that opportunity out of South Africa. Quincy Roberts is someone I know you're very high on, Chris.
Oh, yes. He may win this overall thing. I wouldn't put it past him. He's very good.
Got that big upper body.
USA, Doug Brignole.
particularly for that weight class. And here's Brignole, the youngster from Pasadena, the youngest in this championship.
Dart has the most even physique of anybody up there, actually.
And, of course, Darton, who is the hometown favorite.
And the biggest.
Back over to our head judge, Cliff Sawyer, who will call out the mandatory poses.
Okay, gentlemen, would you just... Everybody take one step to your right, please. Okay,
now, these mandatory poses, I should explain,
thank you,
are what we call the compulsory in the sport of bodybuilding. There's seven all together.
Take a quarter turn to your right, please.
And you cannot hide weak points, and this is the roughest part, because you just have to stand there, do what the judges tell you that they want to see.
Quarter turn to your right.
And you're naked. Cannot hide anything. There you stand. It's either there or it's not.
A quarter turn to your right.
And this also is an opportunity for an opponent to show you up as opposed to in the past when you're out there in just the free form.
Oh, yes. This is the comparative part of the judging. The double arm pose, standard double arm pose.
A lat spread.
Front lat spread. Showing all the musculature, how defined you are, how hard you are.
To your right, side chest pose.
Tell you now, in this particular part of the competition, you have to like Robert's chances against Darton. He compares favorably
very
with the bigger Darton.
Very much.
Relax. Quarter turn to your right.
This is where the bigger man
the
can
toes,
have an advantage
the
if he's evenly developed, but not necessarily.
Relax.
He gets pretty technical here.
A double bicep.
Flex the calf. Back pose. Muscularity is what we're looking for.
Relax, please.
I'd say in this group, the lightweight Swilling would not come out ahead. This is where sometimes the size does make a difference.
Relax, gentlemen. Take a quarter turn to your right. Side chest.
Probably.
Side chest pose. Excuse me.
The least impressive, perhaps, of these poses was that
relax.
Calf.
Side
None of them have the big calf.
No calves are weak in this group. In fact, in the whole competition here
relax.
Today, you don't have
face
outstanding
judges,
calves,
please.
Except for
hands overhead.
The big man
see
from
the
Texas.
Abs and thighs. Abs and thighs.
Calves, thighs, abs. This is where you wish you'd followed the diet if you hadn't.
Relax, gentlemen. May we see a hands on hips most muscular, please.
Muscularity is all that counts in this pose.
Relax, gentlemen. And may we see a crab most muscular.
This is Darton's pose.
Yeah.
And the height does help
him. Relax, gentlemen. You will have 1 minute of free posing for the overall title. Good luck.
Now comes the medley, we call it. And this is my least favorite part of the competition, personally. Because, well, you're posing and you're flexing. You're doing your best, but... I personally don't see how a judge could see all four men at the same time, and you're doing different poses. But the whole idea should be you do your thing, as we say. Do not look at another opponent and just pose as if you're the only man on stage.
Once again, a very comfortable look from Marlon Darton.
Oh, he belongs up there, doesn't he?
That's a pretty proud fellow there as well, Quincy Roberts.
Yeah. He's hopeful of winning this. The man from Pasadena showing his thigh bicep.
This is their Shangri-La, their moment for the Mr. Universe Overall Championship. And the ruling is coming down soon.
And this is where posing really counts. Poise. That preparation in these few seconds.
I can really see what you mean about how Swilling, as the lightweight, has a real problem against these larger weight
suffers,
guys.
He suffers by comparison, and he really does. But he'll be back. He's very good.
The massive upper body of Darton, you have to believe, gives him a big, big edge in this comparative part of this competition.
He gets bigger, it seems, as the contest goes on.
Now the moment that we've been waiting for.
What do you think?
What do you think, Tim?
Well,
Unanimous decision, Mr. Universe, Marlon Darton.
Well, there it is.
The excitement is clear here in Tucson that the homespun star should be Mr. Universe, and he is, and he is elated.
He wears it very well, doesn't he?
Now, you said that Quincy Roberts had a very good choice. Now, we don't know who's second here, but if you had a choice.
Oh, I would definitely say Quincy Roberts was second in this group. And I think the other man would be third. But that's my opinion.
There's that emotion. And the big trophy. I mean, huge trophy. It would take a man the size of Marlon Darton to carry the trophy out of this building here in Tucson.
These are some incredible trophies, I'll tell you. Taller than he is, even.
Presentation being made. And again, tears coming from the eye of Marlon Darton, who really has a great future in front of him. Darton now is headed towards a possible Mr. Olympia championship. Right now, though, he is just to be Mr. Universe, and a Mr. Universe in his hometown of Tucson. We'll be right.
Hi, I'm Paul Horning.
Mr. Universe. Can you believe it, Marlon?
No, man. I'm still a clown 23 or somewhere. I don't know. I'm just shaking, man. It feels great. It's unbelievable.
You've had quite a year. First, now, you're making a movie, I understand.
Mm-hmm.
Tell a little bit about the movie. You're a movie star, and you're Mr. Universe on top of all that. What's the movie called, and tell us some about that.
Okay, first of all, man, I want to thank the Lord and dedicate this trophy and the awards to him and my family and Dan Moyden. And the movie's called Cold Black, and I got the starring role in it, and we'll be filming here in Arizona. It's about a post-slavery type deal where I come from Louisiana and I'm catching trains, I'm fighting Indians, Apaches, and what have you, and find the Lost Dutchman's gold mine. And bottom line is, I go back and buy a plantation and live happy ever after, kind of thing. Yeah.
You know, Marlon, we talked about this earlier. This sport really does combine competition with performance. Do you find that one serves the other? This serves acting, and acting is well served by bodybuilding?
I think what it does, it opens a lot more doors for an athlete to come in with such a prestigious title. It gives you more credibility to your possibilities of making them more doors and opportunities come to me. Yeah.
Is anyone close to this guy, in your opinion?
Somebody compared him to Lee Haney, who is the current Mr. Olympia. And he reminds me a lot of Lee Haney, upper body-wise in particular. And speaking of that, is that your next goal, Mr. Olympia?
Yes. I want to go for the Olympia, and I got my training partner, Sean Neal, over here, who's going to kick my butt all the way to the top of it. Yes, the Olympia is next. Lee Haney, look out, buddy. I'm coming for you.
Marlon, you were tearful and emotional at day's end, and congratulations to you.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you. And fans, friends, thank you. Family, I love you.
Indeed, a very impressive performance for Mr. Universe Marlon Darton. And Chris, you have to be impressed with his size. It had much to do with his victory today.
A lot of beef there. And he's a nice guy, too. It's good to see a good person win. I mean, because it takes a lot of heart going to the contest like that. And he's got it. As you can see, he was very emotional at the end. And it's an emotional experience winning Mr. Universe.
When you look at his persona, too, he's now getting into movies, and he could be a great, great spokesman for the sport of bodybuilding. You get one guy like that, and all of a sudden the youngsters start to say, hey, I want to be like him.
Well, they want to imitate him because he's a winner. It's written all over him, you know. Being a winner, it's more than the physique. It's more than the physical. You see that. But it comes from inside.
Now, you made a statement earlier to many of the young bodybuilders here that it's not how big you are, but how you get the most out of what you have. Now, he is easily the biggest here, but he's also getting the most out of his mass.
Yeah, you see, he's very evenly developed.
Mm-hmm.
And the calves could be better, but they're good as calves go, and he'll get them better even. But when you have a man the size of today's winner, and you put a small man to him who's also as good, the bigger man's naturally going to have the advantage. So that's why that kind of size is awfully hard to fight against.
He also holds the record as being the only competitor here that is taller than his trophy.
Is that right? I'm not surprised. You should see these trophies. I mean, they're incredible.
Bigger than the cactus behind us here in Tucson.
All right.
Chris, pleasure working with you again.
Pleasure working with you, Tim.
For Chris Dickerson, this is Tim Brando saying so long from Tucson, Arizona.